Mama's YouTube channel for another relaxing video. Today's channel naming for my support system list goes to SteRex ASMR, which you can go and check out by clicking the link in the description box below this video. The first few pictures in this video are just to illustrate while I do my intro to the video. What I love about ASMR is the wide variety of things you can do with it, and I love combining my many passions together, which is something you can easily do with ASMR. And those of you who watch my show and tell of Egyptian objects video, you know that my mum and me are total egyptmaniacs, and that we visited Egypt a few years back on a Nile cruise between Luxor and Aswan. This video is a compilation of some of the pictures we took. We've got a nice picture of King Tut's golden death mask there. It's a nice picture also. I think it's supposed to represent King Tut and maybe him. Some of the women that he had in his entourage. They're just illustrations, just to do the intro. That's a nice papyrus drawing there. Maybe a representation of King Akhenaten with his wife Nefertiti. Maybe, I'm not sure. That's what it looks like anyway. Now this one is actually one of my creations. It's a painting on silk that I did, that I still have to this day. I really like that painting. And this one is a portrait made out of painting on silk that I made for my grandmother. It's a picture, it's made from a picture of me and my mom during our Egypt trip, and actually the picture that originated from this is down below in the video somewhere. So come revisit my trip to Egypt with me. So let's go visit Egypt together. We're starting off with some light sightseeing of the sights and scenes around Luxor, where the boat, where the trip started. We started off in Luxor. And these are just a few snapshots that I got of the places that were just around where we were embarked. Nice greenery around the Nile makes everything grow. Lovely palm trees. And some of the more upscale buildings. That is actually one of the surprising things about Egypt, is that you will see a lot of very modern buildings, and right next door some very dilapidated buildings. This is my mum having a grand boat deck. And this is me just lounging about, enjoying the very pleasant weather that we were having. We visited in October 2012. some lovely scenery from around where the boat was embarked. Some more buildings in the style of, well, Egypt. The pool that was on the boat that I managed to get into some total of once throughout the whole trip. It was a lovely pool, but I found the water way too cold in comparison to the very hot weather. It was difficult. There's a bigger view of the boat deck. It was very comfortable. I do not know what my mum was doing or saying when this picture was taken, but it looks funny. It looks like she was having a good laugh. And there's me, duck facing it. And me again, just posing. Trying to not look as fat as I was. I was a bit bigger back then. Some more views of around the boat. Again, at this point, I think we were still in Luxor. Nice picture of the mountains, the dunes, the dunes, I like the way they fade into the horizon. Here's me poking my head out of the swimming pool the one time that I managed to get in. These guys were really funny. They were traveling salesmen, and they would throw whatever you bought up to the boat, and you would throw money down and they would always catch it. I think this picture is of a mosque, but I'm not too sure. There are a lot of things that I'm not too clear on and I don't quite remember. I must admit I did do a little bit of research before making this video, because I just couldn't remember which monuments we visited and which temples were which. I couldn't remember. Nice little picture of a boat sailing along the Nile. And the dunes in the background. With some houses along the shore. The scenery in Egypt is just so pretty. Found it very peaceful. That is another boat, another cruise liner that we passed by. And there it is again. I think our boat was nicer. Some people in the swimming pool. Some people did venture in. I just found it too cold for me. Those are statues that were on the boat that difficult to have them shipped back to France, so we didn't. But yes, my mother really wanted to buy them. They were for sale, to be fair, but difficult. And here are a few pictures of some of the outfits that I bought back from Egypt. I think I bought back like 7. I don't even have pictures of them all. But yeah, those are some of the pictures of some of the outfits that I bought and bought back from Egypt. One of those outfits is actually the dress that I wear in my Cleopatra videos. That's why I use it for those videos, because, you know, it comes from Egypt, so it's fitting. And I still have those shoes. Small glimpse of the inside of our cabin. This is where, I'm not quite sure, I think this is the Temple of Horus in Edfu, but there are a couple of other temples that look very similar, so I'm not too sure. I think it's the Temple of Horus in Edfu, but I'm not quite sure. This is just a picture of a small scale sphinx. Another picture of the same temple. This was like the second day of the trip. You can really see the way the ancient Egyptians really did their engraving well, and for the not very advanced tools that they had, I really find that amazing. Can you imagine building that? Today it would be easier because we have like advanced tools and stuff, machinery, but back then they didn't. They didn't have all of that. Can't imagine what it must have been like, but they were so advanced for, you know, the type of people that they were. So interesting. And the detail they put into them, I mean, it is not so apparent in these pictures, but a little bit later on you'll see some more detailed hieroglyphs, and it's really amazing to think how they, as a primitive people, managed to make those. tells you that the hieroglyphs inside is the name of a pharaoh. This picture isn't very clear, but the hieroglyphs were very, very detailed. I was using a not very good camera. And look at that. That must be hours and hours and hours of working in those hot conditions as well. Now, how did they get? This, our guide explained, is where you can see that part of the men have been sort of like engraved, is where some of the Egyptian people later on in history were trying to erase whoever was represented here. That's their attempt of erasing someone from history. That looks like a gargoyle. Very detailed hieroglyphs. I obviously don't really know what the hieroglyphs say because I don't read fluent hieroglyphs. I have some notions, but this is just way too advanced for me. I know that hieroglyph, but I can't remember. I learnt it, I've been researching, but I can't remember. Nope, I don't know this one. Hieroglyphs will be the subject of a different video. I don't want to say too much, but... So here we have another cartouche, so it's obviously... I've got the name of a pharaoh in it. I don't know which pharaoh though. Now this, maybe it's still the Temple of Horus? I'm really not sure, maybe it's the Temple of Horus seen from the inside. This one I honestly couldn't say. I don't know. Feeling like maybe I didn't go on this trip. It was a long time ago and I don't remember everything. Ah yes, that must have still been the Temple of Horus because the Sphinx, we saw it in some earlier pictures, so I think we're still at the Temple of Horus. This was taken in one of the souks, one of the smaller souks, and in a lot of the pictures I've tried as best I can to block out the faces of the people for their, you know, their for their anonymity. This is the souvenir shop on the boat, so that gives you a little bit of a look of what the boat inside was like. That's the main staircase for the boat. Because the boat had more than one level, obviously. It's very, very pretty. Very modern. Very shiny. Which is a big contrast to a lot of other places in Egypt. The chandelier. Me and my family have a fixation on chandeliers. Now this is cute. This was the cleaning staff on the boat. On various days, we would come back to our rooms, our cabins, and we would find these really cute origami things. And you're going to see there's a few more. They're really well done. And to do them, they would use things that they found in our cabins. Like, if you remember the show and tell, Egyptian show and tell, I did that crown, the headdress, I showed that. And there's the second headdress that I showed. So it just goes to show you that they did use stuff that they found in the rooms. Some of them were actually really cute, but some of them were creepy. You'll see. They probably did this for all the passengers. I don't think it was just us. That scarf that is used right there is actually handmade silk painted. Was a lovely little attention that they did for their passengers. And there's one of the creepy ones. It was positioned right in front of the door when you opened the door and you saw that. And that was just, I think, yeah, and that one, oh. I think we almost had a heart attack when we opened the door and saw that. They had a wicked sense of humour. Can you imagine opening your bedroom door and seeing that? Some more sightseeing. We spent a lot of time just sort of lounging about and looking at the scenery, although we did do excursions. And I also spent a lot amount of time in the gift shop. This is another picture of a souk, but we actually didn't go to any of the big souks. We only went to small ones, so we didn't get a really good idea, good picture of what a really big Egyptian souk can be like. Some more souks. Picture of Mona Lisa was a little out of place, but why not? This was a snake charmer. I've never seen one before. It was fun to watch. As I said, I've tried to block out many faces as I can. I couldn't get them all, but I tried. Well, I don't know what this is. Some huts. But this is something that's a little bit demolished. What a great tour guide I am. Whatever it was, I stood in front of it. And here's the proof. I was there. I may not remember it, but I was there. I like the way the colours have stayed, even after like 3,000 years. The colour, there's still colour there. It's amazing. There's a funny story behind this. Our tour guide explained that one day this block just disappeared. Someone had stolen it during the night, and that's something that's difficult because the monument is closed off at night, and that block was like, I don't know, weighed like 1 ton, so it'd be difficult for one person to steal it, but yeah, it just disappeared one night and was never seen again. Sure which part of the trip we're on right now. If I figure it out, I'll let you know. We must be at the somewhere near the mummified crocodile museum, because there's a crocodile there, and we did visit a mummified crocodile museum, so I think that must be where we are at this point. I must note that I'm not too sure if the pictures are in the right order. I tried my best to get them in the best order I could, but there were like over 200 pictures, so. Thank you. for some big legs. These pictures actually remind me of the excursion to Philae that we did, but that is later in the film, in the video. See? Mummified Crocodile Museum. I must have gotten some of the pictures muddled up, I think. So yes, this is the Mummified Crocodile Museum. Those are the only mummies that we saw in Egypt. We didn't see any other mummies, which I was sad about, because you go to Egypt, you expect to see mummies, but we didn't. Just the mummified crocodiles. Not even a mummified cat. I would have been happy to see a mummified cat. So these are all some of the stuff that we saw in the crocodile museum. You can see in that hieroglyph that there's a crocodile man. As some of you may know, the Egyptians, their deities are part human and part animal. So I don't know which god was represented by a crocodile. Some of these pictures are a little bit out of focus because, as I said before, the camera I was using just wasn't very good compared to the technology that we have these days. Some of the mummified crocodiles with the bandages on, the other ones didn't have their bandages on. Must not have had autofocus on that camera. And I have noticed that some of the pictures that were taken at night tended to be out of focus, so maybe that had something to do with it. I'm not sure. I had, but it was, an old proper camera, so. That looks like something that would have gone on top of the sarcophagus of a mummified crocodile. I think we were told a story about that was like a main crocodile that they considered to be like a god, and that when it died they mummified it and, they worshipped it. So maybe that's what those stone crocodiles are. In some souks taken with the sellers, who had a habit of saying, "It's free until you get to the till." That is a tower from which I think in Egypt day they have like this, someone who calls out to people to do their like daily prayers, and I think that's what that tower thingy was. That is the boat that we stayed on. We took that picture on shore when we were off on an excursion or something, and that's the boat we stayed on. Now this guy, he was funny. We called him the singing boat boy, because he would he's sitting on a piece of wood, literally just a piece of wood, and he hung on to the side of the boat we were sailing in, where we were being transported in, and he just sang songs, and it was really fun. Those are a plant that when you touch them, the leaves will attract. And obviously you can't see that on this picture, but the person who has his hand outstretched showed us. This picture is so contrasting because it shows that you've got very deliberated stuff. Can we Google? Some really deliberated stuff in Egypt, and then you've got this like Coca-Cola dispenser in the middle of nowhere. I found that hilarious. So this is the outing that we did to the Nubian village, and that was a really enjoyable outing. It was very pleasant just drifting along the Nile in the little carrier boat that we were on, and then once in the village it was, I don't know, it was just so quaint, and there were like sellers selling spices and stuff. And some of the people actually got to have a camel ride, but me and my mum, we refused. I'm scared to death of like horses and stuff, so camels was just out of the question. But some of the people from our trip did go. You had the choice. You could either take the bus or ride camel. And there are the camels. There was no way you would get me up on one of those. No freaking way. was one of the camera guys who was filming the whole trip. They made a video that we bought. We had the choice to buy it. So this is, I think that's the the Nubian village. Very sorry if you can hear some tummy gurgles that I'm not able to get out in editing. Very, very sorry. So this building, I think, was the building where we had our Arabic lesson. They gave us a lesson in Arabic, teaching us the basics, of which I remember none, by the way. This nice man helped my mother walk because it was quite a steep walk. And he helped her all the way. Very nice of him. So now we are actually in the Nubian village, and they had crocodiles in the floor with like caging on top. And of course my mother wanted to pick up a crocodile, be it a baby crocodile, but a crocodile altogether, still an happy to pick up the baby crocodile. The doctor, because there was a doctor on the boat and he came with us to some of the excursions. You're going to see him in a second. There you go, there he is. And he actually ran after me for me to hold this baby crocodile, and I didn't want to because I was scared of crocodiles. And but he ran after me with it. But I didn't pick it up in the end. That was a really big crocodile. That one must have been the daddy. This was some sort of oil holding thing. Oh, and this guy was making carpets. Really impressive. Call that a loom? I think that's what you call it. Some more elaborate buildings. Those are houses that were built straight into the cliffs. Was the group of people that we were traveling with. The lady who is standing up in the background with the blue thing on her head, she was our guide for that day out in the Nubian village. She was very nice. And that guy who is standing up is just doing the entertainment. This is where I had difficulty blocking out all the faces, so I just didn't, because I figured that everyone had sunglasses on anyway, so there was really no point in blocking out their faces, and there was too many to do anyway. So this is the temple of Abu Simbel, and I know that because it's written on the picture. These are the henna tattoos that me and my mom got while we were in the Nubian village. There was a lady that you could pay to have a henna tattoo. I got two, my mom got one. is where I'm a little bit confused, because this temple looks a lot like the Temple of Horus that we visited, but from the research that I've done, it seems to be the Temple of Philae. I think this part of where I'm up to in the trip is the Temple of Philae, because this is where we had the Sound and Light show at Philae. But the temple itself reminds me a lot of the Temple of Horus, so I'm not quite sure. But yeah, this is the Sound and Light show. Unfortunately, this is one of the parts where the pictures are very out of focus and you can't really tell what's going on, which is a shame, but the lights are very pretty. I was actually, this excursion actually bored me to death. I was so bored, but the lights were pretty. There were some green pictures in there too, but I think I had to take those out because they just were no good. But we got a wide range of colours in that light and sound show. It's the Temple of Isis. Yes, I think it's the Temple of Isis because the story was all about Isis, and I can also see Isis on the front there, engraved. So, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and say that this might be the Temple of Isis. Maybe the Temple of Isis is situated in a place called Philae. Maybe that's what it is. I'm gonna have to really do some research. Shame a lot of these pictures are out of focus. Maybe one day I'll go back and take some better pictures. You never know. So these pictures are of the entertainment nights, because on the boat in the evenings there was like a different entertainment thing every night. And they were very, very interesting. They had like Egyptian dancers. They had a belly dancer one night. I didn't get to see that one. The belly dancer, I didn't get to see it, but yeah, they had lots of different events, and in some of the pictures you actually see me dancing. This picture I kept in because I thought the effect was really cool, though the picture's completely out of focus. I thought the effect of seeing the guy like transparent, that was really cool. There I am in the gold and black dress with the blue scarf. So yeah, you see me dance in some of these pictures, which really isn't common. But I had quite good fun. Which is something I don't do often. And the shopkeeper said that the dress was supposed to make me look slimmer. You can see my henna tattoo. I also had shorter hair back then. These guys were really good. Their entertainment was really, well, entertaining. There I am, again, up dancing. It's not something I do very often, I'm repeating myself, but... Again, I just couldn't block out all of those faces. There was just too many. I managed to do it on a few of the pictures, but I mean, if I blocked out all the faces there, then you wouldn't have had anything left to see on the picture. Was the view from the boat deck at night when we docked in one of the cities. Very pretty. And this is one of the pictures from the dress up night. There was a dress up night where everybody had to dress up in Egyptian outfits. Oh, and yeah, they had this one night where they had the men get up and they had to play this, how to explain it without it sounding rude, they had this potato dangling between their legs, and they had to, difficult to explain, and the toilet paper, they had to wrap someone in toilet paper as if they were a mummy, and that's the potato thing, there you go. Yeah, the person who won was the one who wrapped the other the quickest. It was fun. I am on the right in the green outfit. I don't know if you can see me. I'm not very visible in this picture. Next one is more visible. That was me and my mum on the dressing up night. Those were the outfits that we chose. Again, you can recognize my my headdress. That was the shopkeeper, the souvenir shopkeeper. We got very friendly with him, actually. I spent like over half the trip in his shop, and I spent over 700 euros of souvenirs in his shop, so yeah, we got along. That's my mum with the shopkeeper. He was a very big help all along the trip, even. Yeah, he was just a really big help. that was the shopkeeper who held the jewelry shop that was next door to the souvenir shop. That's me and the doctor. He was the doctor on the boat. They had like an official boat doctor. Me and my mum together. A wonderful time. This was actually her lifelong dream. She's always wanted to go to Egypt. And nice pose. yeah, she's always wanted to go to Egypt, and for a very long time was convinced that she was never going to get there. But I surprised her by buying her this trip to Egypt. And you know, I decided to tag along. I mean, I couldn't let her go alone. This is the picture that I used to make the portrait. The painting on silk portrait that you saw at the beginning of the video, that's the picture that came from. And back to some lovely scenery, where we have now come back to Luxor at the end of the trip. You can tell by the fact that the picture's very similar to the ones that were taken at the beginning of the trip. This was me taking a picture with this lovely little old couple that came on the trip with us. They were part of our group, and one night actually the man had a trip and fell into the Nile, and that was quite impressive. He wasn't hurt, but he was a bit shaken up. This is the Temple of Karnak, which if I'm not mistaken is actually situated in Luxor. So this is the last excursion that we did. There was one after that to the Valley of the Kings, but we decided not to go, so this was our last excursion. Yes, I know it is a shame that we went all the way to Egypt and decided last minute not to go to the Valley of the Kings. That was seriously a shame, but we had good reasons not to go. The day before, so on this trip to Karnak, my mum had a little a mishap, which completely set us off. My mum hurt her hip a little bit, and it made me feel very bad, and I had like panic attacks. So we decided not to go to the Valley of the Kings. Really, that's a big shame, but you know, It was the best decision for us at the time. We decided not to go. The day we visited Karnak is actually the day where we had the highest temperature. On that day when we went to Karnak, we had 56, yes, I repeat, 56 degrees Celsius. Now, I must admit that the heat is different over in the tropical countries like Egypt and whatever countries there are like that. The heat is different and you put up with it easier. You can handle it better in the higher temperatures than in like France or England, because it's a different type of heat. So up into the 40 degrees, I'm someone who really can't handle heat, not at all. It makes me feel sick and I just can't handle it. But in Egypt, up until like 40, 45 degrees, it was very comfortable. But yeah, I must admit that 56 degrees was too much. Some more cartouches there. I think that must be the cartouche for Akhenaten because you've got the sun disk. That was very characteristic of Akhenaten. That's a broken obelisk that fell down. Is another thing that my mother wanted to buy. It's a giant incense burner, but we didn't, again, because it would have been difficult to get it back to France. That's us having dinner. We always sat in the same places. We all had our designated spots to sit in. And I think that's maybe not the group in its entirety, but that's a part of it. That was some of us. So, this concludes... today's video of visiting Egypt with me, revisiting my trip to Egypt. I hope that you enjoyed it. Obviously this is not one of those videos with like loads of triggers. It's just a calm, soothing trip through Egyptian sights and scenes. So obviously if you're looking for lots of triggers, this isn't the video for you, but if you're like me, an Egypt maniac, and that just listening to a soothing voice talk about, you know, Egypt, something that maybe you really like, then yeah, this is the video for you. So thank you for joining me today. I would like to remind you that the link to the video that I named... I'm sorry. I would like to remind you that the link to the channel I named in the beginning of the video is down in the description of this video, where you will also find my Facebook account for my channel and my Instagram account for my channel. So feel free to click away and add me, follow me, go and check out the channel I named. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next video. Thank you for watching, I wish you a very pleasant morning, afternoon, day, evening, night, whatever time you're watching this video. I wish you a good one. Take care.